advertising.
According to Dr. Gino Abriga, acting district health officer, the hospital serves a population of about 360,000 and has only 398 staff, which she says cripples service delivery.
We have stock out of drugs and late deliveries by national medical stores. This one has really caused a lot of problems to us. In fact, people have been neglecting our health facilities.
Abriga further decried the delayed supply of essential drugs, which has forced patients to visit traditional healers.
They have decided to go now to herbs. Others have gone now to this.
Our ambulance requires constant maintenances and reliably it's taken over 14 years and it really needs a very high cost of maintenance.
Isaiah Nakamia, a hospital board member on the management committee, showed her dismay on the delayed construction works of the hospital. Yet 10 billion was allocated by government for construction works to commence.
You are forwarding a kind of renovation, which is actually a twisting tune to what we are dancing towards. All along here, we have been dancing towards construction, a new hospital. So when you talk about renovation, it actually demorals me as a member of the board who had hopes of having a new face of Masindi.
In response, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Health, Dr. Diana Atwine, said the ministry allocated 10 billion shillings to kickstart the project of constructing the hospital, but will be released in phases, and the contract has been given to UPDF Engineering Department.
They released 5 billion, but the remaining 5 will be able to be released in this coming financial year. And we are going to start with outpatient, maternity and theatre. And so we are going to work on making sure that the designs are complete.
She adds that the challenge of inadequate staffing is at 78% and not so bad, but there is need to motivate them for proper service delivery.
But I've also noted that some equipment require urgent attention, starting from water system, but that one will be dealt with in the phase we are starting the renovation.
Report by Joseph Paguma for the news.